गुड मॉर्निंग वंस अगेन। तो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक फ्लैंज कपलिंग। एक्चुअली वी हैव द इन थर्ड यूनिट व्हाट आर दोस? So first topic we discuss in the third unit is because this is a recording, so that's the reason I'm repeating. First one, division of keys we discuss in the class, and the second one, division of shaft, and the third one is a shaft coupling. So these two are over, and in this design of shaft coupling also, this is the third topic we are discussing today. So this is the three topics we have in a third topic. The last one we are discussing in design of shaft coupling, again in this, the last one is the flange coupling. So a flange coupling, the purpose of this flange coupling is to connect the two shafts and transmit the torque. So previously we discussed in this design of shaft coupling, we have sleeve or muff coupling, sleeve or muff coupling. The second one is the split muff coupling. And the third one is the flange coupling. So the three purposes are the same. To connect the two shafts, this is a to connect the two shafts. So in the sleeve coupling, we already discussed the sleeve is going to overlap these two shafts, and with the help of key, the power is going to transmit in this manner. Split muff coupling is nothing but this sleeve is going to divide into two parts, two half parts. Then the assembly is going to done by keeping the one half portion from the below, one half portion from the top, and by means of nut and bolts we joined this coupling, that is a split muff coupling. This also we discussed. And flange coupling is nothing but here we can observe the figure on the appearing on the screen, how the flange is appearing. Means it is also same, like if we cut this portion here and if we cut this portion here, so it look like the same as a sleeve muff coupling, right? It means here extra material the flanges are adding, so that's the reason this name is given as a flange coupling, right? So flange coupling is two half parts are there. It is generally made of cast iron, and each flange is mounted on the shaft and keyed to it. Here one key is using. So the purpose of the key is to transmit the torque. Suppose this is the source, and the source we are using from the motor to transmit this torque to another shaft. So this is transmitting with the help of this key, and to join these two shafts to maintain the proper connection, we are using this coupling here. Okay, and the faces are turned upright angle to the axis of the shaft. One of the flange has a projected proportions, and the other flanges has a corresponding recess. So here the one flange is having the projections here, and these projections are going to sit inside the another flange. That is the meaning of this one. And this helps to bring the shaft into one line. Means the shafts are in a linear position. Means see, this is the one axis of the shaft, and this another axis of the shaft is going to collinear. That is the meaning of the this helps to bring the shafts into the line, and to maintain the alignment. And these two flanges are coupled together by means of nut and bolts. We are using the nuts and bolt here, you can see on the figure. And the flange coupling is adapted for heavy loads, and for the large shaft also this is used. Okay, So this is the somewhat theory. The theory you can expect for the two mask questions. What type of material is used? What type of key is used here? And what is the purpose of this coupling? This kind of question you can use here. You can see here. And coming to this flange coupling, there are three types of couplings. One is a unprotected type of flange coupling, protected type of flange coupling. Categories we have in this flange coupling. So the design procedure is same for these three all, but the proportions are the different. What are the proportions here? The proportions are nothing but here. The length is here, the flange from here to here, how much? 1.5D, and this is also 1.5D. Capital D1 is the diameter of the hub, that is the diameter of the flange, that is D1 is equal to 3D. D2, outer diameter of the flange, is 4D, and D, capital D, equal diameter of the this just wait a moment. Can you see my whatever this one screen? Can you see the screen, my? Please respond to my question. Are you able to see my screen? Hello. Can you see my screen? Are you able to listen my words, Babu?
No, sir. No. I can't see the screen.
It's not appearing. Now is it appearing, my screen?
Yes, sir.
So these three are the categories in the flange coupling. And this one, unprotected type of flange coupling, protected type of flange coupling, marine type of flange coupling. So these three are the categories in this flange coupling, not in this design of shaft. So design of shaft coupling. Of course, this is the main topic, is the design of shaft coupling. In this topic, these are the three topics. And for these three, the design procedure is same. I'm repeating this one. For these three type of couplings, the design procedure is same, but the proportions are different. Proportions means the figure on the figure is appearing here. Capital D, capital D1, capital D2, length of this sleeve. These are all the proportions. But the proportions are the different, but these three types of couplings. Now, unprotected type of flange coupling. Each shaft is keyed to the boss of the flange. And with the counter sunk key, just now I said for 2 marks they will ask what type of key is using here. So here sunk type of key is using here, and flanges are coupled together by means of bolts. You can see on the figure. So unprotected type of flange, the name indicating there is no protection for this flange. It means here the flanges are appearing in a straight manner. If this flange is covering these bolts in this manner, that becomes a flange type, protected type of flange coupling in this manner. See here, the bolt is covering in this manner, right? So this is a protected type. Here, unprotected type of flange coupling, right? That is the difference. And generally here, 4, 3 or 6 bolts are using here, and the keys are stated a right angle along the circumference of the shaft in order to divide the weakening effect of the caused by the keyway. Now here I said the design procedure is same, but proportions are the different. For this type of shaft coupling, the proportions are, I'm writing now, the proportions are capital D, outer diameter of the hub, capital D, this is the hub, the outer diameter of the hub, I'm drawing here capital D, okay, this capital D means outer diameter of the hub, that is equal to 2D, first point, first proportion, capital D equal to 2D, where D is the diameter of shaft, right? The second portion, coming to the second portion, capital D1. What is capital D1? Capital D1 is the pitch circle diameter of the bolt. See here, the bolts are arranged in a specific manner. So this circle I have drawn here, this diameter of the circle is referred as a, capital D1. What is capital D1? Pitch circle diameter of the bolt. So that is capital D1, that is 3D. Right? And the next proportion, third proportion, that is capital D2. So what is capital D2? Capital D2 is the outside diameter of the flange. So this is the flange, outside diameter of the flange. This one represents the capital D2, outside diameter of the flange. So for this, the empirical relation is capital D1 plus capital D1 minus D. Okay. So that is nothing but 2D1 minus D. So what is 2D1? 2 into D is a 3D. D1 is a 3D minus capital D is a 2D. So total how much? 6 minus 2, that is 4D. So D2 is how much? D2 is the 4D. So where D is the diameter of the shaft. Here D is the diameter of the shaft. So all are in mm bound. Don't forget this one. All the values we are getting here in terms of mm. And the next proportion, this is the third proportion. The fourth one is T suffix F. So T suffix F is nothing but thickness of the flange. How much thickness we are maintaining here? That is the thickness of the flange. So that is TF. So TF is, the empirical relation is 0.5 into D. So where D is the diameter of the shaft. T suffix F is thickness of the flange. This is the fourth proportion. Now, fifth proportion, number of bolts. So number of bolts we need to decide. Number of bolts. So how many number of bolts we are using here? So three bolts we have to use for the diameter of the shaft if we get the answer 40 mm. So if you, while calculating the diameter of the shaft, if we get 40 mm, right, then we need to take the number of bolts for this coupling 3. And number of bolts 4 we need to take when the diameter of the shaft, if we get 100 mm. It means 41 to 100 if we get, then we can select the number of bolts as a 4. And the number of bolts we can select 6 when the diameter of the shaft will get from the 101 to 180 mm. Suppose if we get the any one of the value middle are equal these values, then number of bolts we can select as a 6. The number of bolts are 3, 4, 6. Depends on the shaft diameter we need to select. So these 5 are the proportions for the unprotected type of flange coupling. Right? So this is the first category. Now the second category, protected type of flange coupling. Protected type of flange coupling, the name indicating here, the flange is protected type, means see the shape, how the protection. The protection is providing for the bolts and nut in this manner, right? Bolts and nut are protected. The flanges on the two halves of coupling in order to avoid from the danger for the workman. The proportions are here. The purpose is same. The purpose is to transmit the torque and maintain the collinear of the shafts, right? The proportions are the thickness of the, only the thickness of the flange, T suffix F. T suffix F. That is first one. The thickness of the protective type of flange coupling is TF, that is equal to 0.25D, where D is the diameter of the shaft. The other proportions of the coupling is same as the unprotected type of flange coupling. What are those? The first one in the unprotected type of flange coupling, diameter of the hub 2D. The second one, diameter of the pitch circle bolt diameter D1 3D, and the third one, length of the hub 1.5D, and the fourth one, outside diameter of the flange D2, that is 4D. So these are all same, only the thing is thickness of the flange is going to change, that is 0.25 into D. So for the previous case, what was the value? Thickness of the flange 0.5 into D. So this is the difference here, 0.5 in the previous case. In now this case, 0.25 into D, right? The other things are same. Remember this one. Okay. Now the design procedure for this also same. Now third one, marine type of flange coupling. So in this marine type of flange coupling, flanges are held together by means of tapered headless bolt and numbering from the 4 to 12 depending upon the diameter of the shaft. So see here, the nut and bolts we are using here in the tapered manner, headless tapered manner. In the previous two cases, for the nuts, there was a heads, you can observe here. This is for the unprotected type of flange coupling. And here the head is for the protected type of flange coupling. But in this diagram, if you observe, only nuts are appearing, but there is no head for the bolts. So that means the bolts we are using here without head, nothing but taper headless bolt. And number of this type of bolts we are using depends upon the shaft diameter. Now proportions for this type of coupling is, the thickness of the flange, T suffix F, thickness of the flange, T suffix F, is D by 3, where D is the diameter of the shaft, and taper for the bolt. Here, type of bolts we are using, right? So that reason, taper for bolt. How much taper for bolt we are maintaining? 1 inch, 1 in 20 to 1 in 40, right? And the pitch circle diameter for the bolt, we are using this taper type of bolt now. So that reason, how much distance, means the, suppose this is a shaft coupling, I'm drawing front view here, we are keeping the this taper type of bolts. So if I draw this one imaginary line here, this one is called pitch circle diameter of the bolt. So pitch circle diameter of the bolt, pitch circle dia of bolt, how much this one? 1.6 into D. So this one is denoted as a capital D1. Okay, so where D is the diameter of the shaft, and outside diameter of the flange. Outside diameter of the flange means from here to here, the diameter is referred as a outside diameter of the flange. So this is denoted by D2, and the relation, empirical relation, 2.2 into D, where the D is the diameter of the shaft. So just now I said, what is the number of bolts are going to depends on the shaft diameter. So this is the first one, this is the first parameter, the second one, the third one, and this is the fourth one, and the fifth one, number of bolts. Number of bolts are starting from minimum bolts is 4, and maximum bolts we are using 12. So based on the shaft diameter, see, you can see in the table, if you get the shaft diameter 35 mm to 55 mm, then you can select the 4 number of bolts. Suppose if you get the 56 to 150 diameter of the shaft, small d, then you can select the number of bolts as a 6. Suppose if you get the answer diameter of the shaft 151 to 230 diameter of the shaft in mm, then you can select the number of bolts as a 8. And 231 to 390, if you get the diameter of the shaft, this is the diameter of the shaft. If you get this answer, then you can select the 10 number of bolts. And above 390, if you get the answer 390 mm and above, then you can select the answer number of bolts as a 12. So this table, you need to remember, this table represents the fifth proportion. Okay. So these are the proportions regarding to the flange coupling. Now we are going to the design procedure. So design procedure, I'm explaining now. This design procedure contains of four topics. First one, design for hub. Second one, design for key. Third one, design for flange. Fourth one, design for bolts. In the previous case also, we discussed in the classroom for the muff coupling, split muff coupling. What are those? For the muff coupling, design for shaft, design for muff, design for key. Coming to the design split muff coupling, design for shaft, design for muff, design for key, for the fourth one, design for bolts. In the same manner, here also we are discussing about the design of flange coupling for four parameters: design for hub, design for key, design for flange, design for bolts. Right now, first one, design for hub. So here, designing the hub, how much diameter we need to maintain. So for this design hub, designing hub, nothing but hub is nothing but this is the portion. So this portion is called hub. Okay, so see here, hub, how it look like. The hub is appearing in this in the manner of a hollow shaft, right? This is the outer diameter of the shaft, this is the inner diameter of the shaft, right? So one hollow circle, see, I'm drawing on the figure, right? One hollow circular shaft is appearing. So the reason, the purpose of this flange coupling is to transmit the torque. So the equation, torque transmitted by the hollow shaft is capital T equal, as you know, this one, pi by 16 sigma s, and T power 3 1 minus k power 4, right? The outer diameter of the hub usually taken as twice the diameter of the shaft. Outer diameter of the hub, capital D, is taken as a twice the diameter of the shaft. Just now we discussed about the proportion, right? And including the shear stress, maybe the shear stress is going to checked here. Now the proportion for the length of the hub is 1.5D. Just now we discussed, right? Now this value is 2D. Now here, the shaft diameter is going to calculated by this equation. Torque transmitted by the solid shaft is T equal pi by 16 sigma s T power 3. With this relation, capital D is going to calculated. Otherwise, question itself mentioned the small d value, right? Now, substitute this d value here, you will get the shaft shear stress value, sigma s. The sigma s is determined. Sigma s is determined and checking. Checking with permissible value. Permissible value. What is the checking here? The induced shear stress. Induced shear stress is nothing but by using this equation we calculated. This stress is called here induced shear stress. That should be less than the permissible shear stress. This permissible shear stress is given in the question. Right? If we satisfy this relation, then whatever the proportions we calculated and the diameter of the shaft, whatever we got, these all are under safe condition, right? And where D is the diameter of the hub and K is the diameter ratio, that is Di by D naught. So Di is the diameter of the shaft and D naught is the outer diameter of the hub, capital D, right? That is D by capital D. So this is the design for the hub, first point. Now second one is the design for the key. So design for the key, we discussed already. In design of key, separate topic is there in the third unit. And in the muff coupling also, we discussed the design of key. And in the sleeve muff coupling, split muff coupling also, we discussed about the design of key. So design of key, the diameter based on the diameter of the shaft, based on the diameter of the shaft, we are going to taking the proportions of the key, width of the key, thickness of the key, length of the key, right? This is the one way. Another way is based on the proportions. What are the, based on the empirical relation, what is this? Width of the key is D by 4, thickness of the key is D by 6, and the length of the key is equal to D by 3. This is for the rectangular key. And width to thickness, these are all equal to D by 4 if it is rectangle key. So this is the one way, this is the another way. This is the based on data book. By seeing the data book based on the diameter of shaft, we need to select these values. And if the value itself, the given question, the relation crushing stress of the key is equal to twice the shear stress of the key. This value is given means, suppose crushing stress is 120 megapascal and shear stress is 60 megapascal, right? So what we are, this is the crushing stress. By seeing these values, what we can conclude, crushing stress is equal to twice the shear stress. It means 120 equal 2 into 60. That is 120 equal 120. So when we see this condition, then we need to go through this relation, right? Square key. Now at this situation, square key we need to use. So this is the proportions, the procedure for the selection of the proportions of the key. Generally, the key is having in this shape I'm drawing on the screen. Right? And this is the width of the key. This is the thickness, T, and the length of the key is L. So these physical parameters we need to take by seeing the, either we can see from the data book or we can see, we can select from this empirical relation. After calculating width, after calculating this width, thickness, length of the key, we need to check. What is checking here? We need to check. What checking here? Whether what we selected, the W value, T value, L value are in a safe condition or not, we need to check. To check this one, we need to select two failure modes of the key. Already we discussed failure modes of the key. First one, the key is going to take place, failure takes place in a shear. The second, the key is going to, failure takes place in a crushing. right? These two, with these two mode only, the key is going to fail. It means the shear stress we need to calculate, induced shear stress, and the crushing stress we need to calculate. This is called as induced crushing stress, and we need to compare with the permissible values. Permissible shear stress, permissible crushing stress. The induced value, always we need to get less than the permissible value. Then only our, whatever the values we take in here, W, thickness, width, length of the key, all are under safe condition, nothing but safe for the using utilizing purpose. Design is safe, right? So what is the shear stress? The procedure, the procedure is shear resisting force for the key material is F suffix S is sigma S area. So what is the area? Shear area we need to consider, that is W into L. Already we discussed this one in classroom. And crushing resistance for the key material, F suffix C, that is sigma C into area. So what is the area? L into T by 2, right? So the purpose of this one is to calculate the Fs and sigma S and sigma C. So Fs is calculated by torque transmitted relation. Torque T is equal to force into distance, perpendicular distance. So with this relation, Fs or Fc is equal to 2 into torque transmitted by the shaft or key, 2 into T by capital D. Right? So with this relation, we can get the answer of Fs or Fc. Substitute Fs and Fc here. And these proportions, just now we taken from this relation, with these two relation, that is W into L, L into T by 2. Substitute here and get the value of sigma S and sigma C. That is nothing but induced shear stress, induced crushing stress. And after calculating this one, we need to check with the permissible values. If we calculated value, our calculated value getting less than this permissible value, our selector proportions are under safe condition. That comment we need to write. So this is the second design point in the design of flange coupling. The third point, design for flanges. So here, flange is nothing but, I'm showing again here. So this extended portion from here to here, this extended portion from the hub, around the circular manner, the material is extended. This one is a flange. Separately, this flange I'm drawing here. Separately, the flange I'm drawing here. Right? And having somewhat thickness, this one. And the nut and bolts are going to fix it in these holes, through these holes. Right? And here, the hashed lines I drawn here, this is the lines because the hub I separated. The hub portion I separated from this hollow portion. So that reason I drawn this as a cross-sectional view. Right? This is a flange. Okay? So here, what we are calculating? Thickness of the flange is going to calculated. Thickness of the flange is going to calculated. Or shear stress due to this region. Because the flange is at the hub. This is the hub. This is the hub. Right? On this hub, the flange is going to sit. So this hashed lines and this hashed lines, both are matched. Okay? So it means the flange is going to sit here on this hub portion, right? While transmitting the torque, there will be a shear stress at this junction where, just wait, I'm showing. While transmitting the torque at this junction, there will be a shear stress, right? Here, at this junction, there will be a shear. right? So here what we are doing, the shear stress, either thickness of the flange or shear stress, induced shear stress, we are calculating and comparing with the permissible value. These permissible values are always given in the question. No need to confuse, right? Permissible values are always given in the question itself. And we need to check. Either we have to calculate thickness of the flange or induced shear stress and compared with the permissible value, right? So here, torque transmitting. I am telling about torque transmitting. So torque transmitting, general, what is the equation? General equation, force into D by 2. So D by 2 is the diameter of the hub by 2. Diameter of the hub by 2. So this is the actual equation to transmit the torque. Means here, while it is rotating, the torque transmitting. So how much torque because of this much of force acting here, tangential force into this perpendicular distance, right? So force into perpendicular distance that I am writing here. Basic equation, force into D by 2. So how much the force acting here, that we need to know. D is generally we can calculate 2D. D is the diameter of shaft. But what is the F? F is a capital. F represents the force acting due to transmitting the torque. How much that one, the force value here, circumference of the hub, see here, this is the hub, this circumference of the hub. What is the circumference? Pi into D into thickness of this portion, thickness of this portion is referred as the thickness of the flange, capital T, sorry, small t, suffix F. And shear stress along this portion, the hashed portion I'm drawing here, along this portion, shear stress. This one represents the force acting on the hub, that is capital F. Pi D is the circumference. Along the circumference, the thickness, along the thickness, the shear stress is acting, that is the force. This one we can also write as a, in this manner, shear stress equal to force by area, right? This force, this one, and what is the area? The area is along this circumference, the hashed color portion, hashed lines portion, that is the area. How much this one? Because it is appearing in a circular manner, I'm writing the pi d, and how much thickness this one, tf, that is the area. So d is an mm, thickness is an mm square, right? Shear stress is a newton per mm square, newton per mm square. So this square gets cancelled, newton is the answer, the force is measured in a newtons, that is the meaning. Okay, here the in this third topic we can calculate either TF or shear stress. We need to calculate, suppose shear stress we are calculating, then we need to check with the permissible value. That value should be always less than the permissible value. If you get the answer by satisfying this condition, then you need to write design is safe. Design is safe. So what we need to calculate, shear stress is determined. And check. Permissible value. Right? So this is the third design point. Now fourth design point, design for bolts. So while transmitting the power or torque, the bolts are subject into shear stress. Because see here, while the transmitting the torque, the bolts here in this portion are going to break up. How they are going to break up? Because half of the portion is carrying in the one flange, another half portion is going to carry in the another half shaft. Because of sudden impact, the bolts are subjected to shear failure. Bolts are subjected to shear failure. So remember here, the bolts are failures, the bolts are going to fail in a shear only. This point you need to remember. The first one, design for the bolts. Load acting on each bolt, how much due to the shear? Pi by 4 into load acting on each bolt, capital F. Pi by 4 into diameter of the bolt square into shear stress. This shear stress related to the bolt. The previous shear stress is related to the flange. And the other three previous shear stresses belongs to the this key. Okay, don't get confused. Here I am using one shear stress. Here I am using another shear stress. Here I am using another shear stress. These three stresses are different, right? Don't get confused. And total load acting on all bolts is, I am multiplying with the N value. Okay. And torque transmitting. Torque transmitting is nothing but force into diameter of the pitch circle divided by 2. Diameter of the pitch circle, why I am telling? Because diameter of the pitch circle is here because transmitting torque, the force is going to generated here on the diameter of the pitch circle. Okay, so because this reason, the force acting here, force into perpendicular distance. So what is it? Perpendicular distance, capital D1 by 2. What is capital D1? See here, capital D1 is the diameter of the pitch circle, 3D, right? So that is the meaning. So D1 by 2. So force we calculated here. So again, I'm writing torque transmitted is pi by 4 into dB square into sigma s into N number of bolts into D1 by 2. This is a basic equation. Okay. With this equation, diameter of the bolt is calculated. Diameter of the bolt is calculated in mm. Right, and this is the diameter we are calculating based on the torque transmitting. It's nothing but here the shear stress is involving here, right? And if the bolts are made of sufficient diameter, after calculating this diameter in mm, suppose this is a sufficient diameter, but because the material whatever we are using, that is a suppose lesser strength than the coupling, so this bolt is going to subjected to crush, nothing but crushing failure we can find. So we need to overcome that crushing failure also, because always it is while transmitting the torque, the sides of the bolts are going to subjected to the impacts from the flanges, that leads to the crushing in the bolts. So that crushing also we need to overcome. So the crushing resistance of the bolt, FC equal crushing stress into area. Crushing area. Area means crushing area. That is sigma C into area. Crushing area, what is the crushing area? D1, diameter of the bolt, D1. See, suppose this is the bolt. Suppose this is the bolt locating in inside the flange. So this much of place occupied by the shaft flange. Okay, so this is the thickness TF, thickness of the flange, and what is this one? This is the one diameter of the D1, diameter of the bolt D1, D1 into TF, thickness of the flange into sigma C. Crushing resistance on the bolt or crushing resistance of bolt. So like this, how many bolts are we are using? Maybe 3, maybe 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. These many bolts are we are using. So based on the number of bolts, number of bolt, the crushing stress, the crushing resistance is going to calculate it. So that reason n number of bolts I'm writing. If I write n here, we can write is a 3, n as a 4, n as a 6, n as a 12, n as a 14, like that. We can select any value, right? So this is the crushing resistance of the bolt. With this relation, sigma c is going to calculate it here. With this relation, sigma c is going to calculate it in terms of megapascal. This is the induced crushing stress for the this flange coupling, and this one is going to determine in this fourth topic. This is going to determine it and checked with permissible value. So what is this one? This calculated value is called as a induced crushing stress. Here I'm writing induced crushing stress, always less than the permissible crushing stress. This condition at any cost we need to satisfy. Then only our design for the bolt is under safe condition. So this is the how we need to solve the design procedure. For this design procedure, remember in examination, external examination, 15 marks allotted. This failure parts we need to draw, right? How I am drawing the failure parts? This one, and for the key, there are two failure modes. Shear failure means this is the one failure mode. This is the one shear failure mode, and the crushing failure mode is. This is another crushing failure mode, right? This failure parts we need to draw. So same like what I practiced on the screen, title design for design of flange coupling, design for hub, design for key, design for thick flange, and design for bolts. In this same manner, we need to practice, right? If the question is asking for the derivation, design procedure, you need to write these all things. Same thing, if the question is asked for the numerical, instead of writing these comments, see here what I written, sigma s is determined and checked with the permissible value, right? If you get this less than value, then design is safe. We need to write like this, right? So in the same manner, instead of writing these comments, we need to write the answer, right? So we'll go through the one problem. See, this is another one, see Babu, how to select the number of the key proportions, width of the key, thickness of the key, right? If we get the diameter of the shaft 6, the width of the key is 2, thickness of the key is also 2. It means it is a square key, right? If we get the answer 1110, if we get the answer diameter of the shaft as a 1110, the width of the key is 32, thickness is a 18 mm. So this is the rectangular key. Okay, so this table at any cost you need to remember. So this is the one problem, example problem I'm showing here. Design a cast iron protective type of flange coupling. Question itself mentioning what type of coupling this one. It is a protective type of flange coupling, right? And transmitting the power, first I'm writing the given data. How much the top power transmitting, capital P is equal to 15 kilowatts into 10 to the power of 3 watts at a speed 900 rpm, right? From an electric motor to compressor. So from this side motor is there and this side compressor is there. To run the compressor, here the coupling is using. Purpose of the coupling is given in the question. And the service factors may be assumed as a 1.35. The service factor is given. Service factor CS is given as a 1.35. The following are the permissible values. See here, question itself mentioned here, permissible values are shear stress for the shaft bolt key material. Shear stress for the shaft bolt key material is 40 megapascal. Shear stress for the shaft or key or bolt, these three are given 40 megapascal, right? Crushing stress for the bolt and key. Crushing stress for the bolt and key. How much this one? 80 megapascal. Right? And the shear stress for the cast iron. Shear stress for the cast iron. Cast iron is nothing but the flange. How much this one? 8 megapascal. And question itself asking, draw a with a neat sketch for the coupling. So for this coupling, you need to draw the diagram. This diagram at any cost, you need to remember. If you forget this diagram, you will lose the 3 to 5 marks. The marks is allotted for the diagram. Okay, immediately right side of the given data. See how I am drawing here. This is the given data. Immediate right side of the given data, I am drawing the diagram. Same like this, you need to draw in examination also, right? Now, what is the design procedure? Design for hub, first we are calculating. First one, hub designing. First one, hub we are designing. So what is the procedure is? It is, I'm considering hollow circular shaft. So that's the reason, 5/16, the sigma S, into capital D power 3 into 1 minus K power 4. This is a basic equation, right? With this equation, so here, sigma S is calculating and checking with the permissible value. To calculate this one, first we need to get the answer capital D and ratio of diameter. So for this, again, we need a small d value. So that reason, torque transmitted by the solid shaft T is equal to 5/16 sigma S into D power 3. So what is D power 3 here? D power 3 is a T into 16 by pi into sigma S. So this one I'm sending this here, square cube root of 3 into 16 by pi sigma S. Okay. So this is the equation, and now T value, I don't know. To get T value, power relation is there. P equal 2 pi n T by 60. So with this relation, T equal power value 15 into 10 to the power of 3, 15 into 10 to the power of 3 into 60 by 2 pi into 900. How much this value? Just tell me the torque value. The torque is in Newton meter. Tell me the torque value. Tell me the torque value of, calculate it, do it fast.